Warm greeting to all of you. We are going to see about symmetry elements and symmetry operations present in group theory. Group theory is a very powerful mathematical tool that allows us to rationalize and simplify many problems in chemistry. A group consists of a set of symmetry elements which is associated with the symmetry operations that completely describes the symmetry of a particular object. Now we are going to see about the definition of symmetry elements and symmetry operations. Before that, we have to know about symmetry. The word symmetry is derived from Greek, which is present in geometrical figures, crystalline solids and molecules. Now we are going to consider square and rectangle. In this, square is said to be more symmetrical than the rectangle due to the fact that all the sides of the square are equal, whereas in a rectangle opposite sides are equal. Square is more symmetrical due to the presence of large number of symmetry elements and symmetry operations in it. So here I have given some naturally occurring materials such as butterfly, sunflower, rose, starfish, peacock and leaves of a plant. All are symmetric in nature. So from this we conclude symmetricity present in nature itself. So first we will see about the definition of symmetry elements. It is a geometrical entity such as a line or a plane or a point about which an operation of rotation or reflection or inversion is carried out. And then we are going to see about the symmetry operations. This is a movement of a molecule such that the resulting configuration of a molecule is indistinguishable from the original one. So the molecule is taken into an equivalent configuration or an identical configuration. Example, consider H2 molecule of configuration 1 present in this slide. So it can be rotated by 180 degree to give a configuration 2. Application of rotation operation twice produces the identical configuration 3. So here I have given the image of formaldehyde which is having the formula HCHO. The first image shows the rotation through an axis leading to equivalent configuration, and the second image shows the rotation through an axis leading to identical configuration. In this slide, we will discuss about the symmetry elements and the corresponding symmetry operations. There are 5 symmetry elements. First one is proper axis of symmetry, which is denoted as CN. This corresponds to rotation once or several times by an angle theta equal to 2 pi by n. The next one is plane of symmetry, which is denoted as sigma. It corresponds to one or more reflections in a plane. Third one is improper axis of symmetry, SN. This corresponds to rotation about the axis followed by reflection in a plane which is perpendicular to the rotational axis. Fourth one is center of symmetry. It is denoted as I. This corresponds to inversion of all atoms through center of symmetry. The final one is identity element, E. This operation leaves the molecule unchanged. First, we will see about proper axis of symmetry elaborately. It is an imaginary line which passes through the molecule about which rotation can be carried to attain an equivalent configuration. So the symbol for proper axis of symmetry is CN, where N is known as the order of axis. So it is given by the formula N equal to 2 pi by theta, where theta is the minimum angle of rotation to obtain the equivalent configuration, and N is non-zero positive integral values. Here I have given the structure of water molecule. This water molecule is rotated by an angle of 180 degree about an axis to get equivalent or identical configuration. So the order of axis is 2, and the rotation and the axis is known as C2 axis of symmetry. That is, we are performing the rotation twice to get an identical configuration. So N equal to 2 pi by theta. Here pi is 180, so 2 into 180 by theta, we are performing the rotation about an angle 180 degree. So 360 by 180 is equal to 2. N is equal to 2 for water molecule and it corresponds to C2 axis of symmetry. Here I have given some other examples like boron trichloride, sulfur dioxide and benzene. Boron trichloride molecule has the C3 axis of symmetry. The minimum angle of rotation to obtain the equivalent configuration is 120 degree in boron trichloride. If we are performing the rotation through boron, means it gives the C3 axis. If we are performing the rotation through Cl, means that gives the C2 axis of symmetry. So if there are n axes of different orders in a molecule, the axis with the highest order is said to be principal axis. In boron trichloride, C3 is principal axis. Sulfur dioxide molecule belongs to C2 axis of symmetry. That is, we are performing the rotation twice to get an identical configuration. The benzene molecule is having C6 axis of symmetry. That is, we are performing the rotation 6 times to get an identical molecule. So next one is plane of symmetry. It is an imaginary plane within the molecule which divides it into two halves. One is mirror image of the other. Here I have given the representation of mirror images of our hand. So the mirror is used as a reflection plane here. If reflection of any atom of molecule is carried out on a particular plane of symmetry, it coincidences with another equivalent atom. So the plane of symmetry is nothing but a reflection plane. So the reflection plane can be classified into three types based on their rotation relation with the principal axis. Here we have taken platinum tetrachloride molecule. This is having square planar structure. The plane which is consisting platinum and all chlorine is perpendicular to C4 axis in this molecule. So a plane referred as horizontal plane if it is perpendicular to the principal axis. Here the plane is perpendicular to the principal axis, so it is having sigma H plane, that is horizontal plane. So a plane drawn vertically through the principal axis. Here we have given C2 axis as a principal axis and we have drawn the plane vertical to principal axis. That plane is said to be vertical plane, sigma V plane. So in water molecule, we are having two sigma V planes. So water molecule has a sigma V plane which passes through the principal axis containing O atom and it bisects a line between hydrogen atoms. And the vertical plane which bisects two perpendicular C2 axis is called as dihedral plane. So if we are having many number of C2 axis on that, if a plane bisects the C2 axis, means that is called as dihedral plane. So dihedral planes are present only in molecules having more than one C2 axis. So here I have given allene, that is propadiene, as an example which is having the dihedral plane in it. Next one is improper axis of symmetry. It is an imaginary line which is passing through the molecule about which rotation followed by reflection in a plane perpendicular to the rotational axis can be performed to attain an equivalent configuration. So an imaginary axis of symmetry is called as what means rotation reflection axis. So here if we take transdichloroethylene, this provides an example with the S2 axis of symmetry. This molecule possesses C2 axis and a sigma H. First we are performing the rotation about 180 degree and we are reflecting the molecule. It gives the equivalent configuration. So center of symmetry, this is a point such that any line drawn through it meets the same atom in equal distances but in opposite directions. If we draw a line from here, it meets the same atoms in opposite directions. So hydrogen peroxide molecule, ethylene molecule and transdichloroethene belongs to center of symmetry. That center of symmetry is also called as center of inversion. So finally, we are going to study about identity element, a symmetry operation which brings back the molecule to the original orientation, that is original configuration, is called identity operation. So this is the operation of doing nothing. That means that this symmetry element leaving the molecule unchanged. So the corresponding symmetry element is called identity, which is denoted as E. So from the German word Inge, meaning unity. So all the molecule will possess identity. So in this we have studied about symmetry elements and symmetry operations elaborately. Thank you.